Hi everyone, I'm Eric Anthony, and I'll be presenting on bridging gaps. So, this is a picture of my grandma, and I love spending time with her. She has so many stories to share, and her experiences are simply fascinating, and I truly enjoy them. And I treasure every moment with her. And I really wish I could spend more time with her, but since she lives in India, I don't really get to spend much time with her. When was the last time you have all spent time with your grandparents, or maybe someone elderly, or interacted with them? For most of us, it would most probably be during recent holidays, such as Chinese New Year, or maybe Christmas. And this is a growing problem, and we often don't usually get to meet them. Now, we often hear about the increasing numbers of elderly in our society, societies which look something like this, a triangle. And previously, it was considered that the youth were much larger in size and the elderly were much smaller in size. But nowadays, when we take a look at society, societies are becoming something like this, where the elderly are much larger in population and the young are much smaller. Now, if you're someone who gets chills from very scary statistics, then be forewarned. It is estimated that the population of people over the age of 60 will reach 1 billion in the next decade. Now, that means one in every seven people you meet will most probably be an elderly person. Now, I'm sure you guys might be wondering, how exactly does that concern me? How does that affect me? So, let's talk about Singapore. By the year 2030, it is estimated that one in every five residents in Singapore will be a senior. Shocking, isn't it? Now, this practically means that every household will have at least one elderly person to take care of. Quite a big responsibility. And to further complicate the situation, elderly people have a number of issues, and these issues can come in the form of health and mobility. Now, personally, it's not the statistics that scare me or make me feel nervous. It's more what we're doing about the situation of the elderly. How are we going to help them? How will we take care of the elderly? Now, the government has come up with many initiatives, and I commend the Singapore government for that, because unlike many countries, they've already implemented various programs and schemes, and that's great. And some such schemes are the silver support scheme, building a large number of old age homes, and providing major government subsidies. But, is that really enough? Should we do something about it? And at first, for a long time actually, I thought that was enough. You know, the government's helping out the elderly, we're doing our part, the elderly are happy, and everything's good. But that all changed when I started my IB personal project. And the topic I chose was dementia and was among the elderly. And as part of the project, I decided to research. And I researched at this home, and it's called the St. Joseph's Old Age Home. So I volunteered there and helped out with the healthcare workers for about a month. And when I first met the people working there, they were all the health workers were very nice, and they seemed to interact with all the patients fairly well. But what I noticed when I first met all the patients was that they were sitting alone in a corner, minding their own business, sitting passively, not talking to anyone. And it seemed rather bland and went against what I had previously researched, where since the elderly had all these facilities and all these new plans to help improve their lives, they should be happy, but that's not what I saw. So I decided to approach the elderly one by one. And one of the elderly people I approached was a woman. And I won't say her name for identity purposes, but she was actually a teacher. And her son lives abroad. And basically, she's all alone in Singapore in this old age home. And when I talked to her, she was extremely happy talking to me about her school life, how she enjoyed all the antics her students did, and it was quite entertaining to listen to her. But as I talked to her, I had one question that kept growing in my mind. Was she really happy? Was she happy? And at the end of our conversation, just before leaving, I asked her, "Are you happy?" And one would assume that since she's so energetically talking to me that she's had so much fun about her life and everything, you'd assume that she is happy. And her reply was fairly shocking. For she said, "No, I want to go home." And that truly set me aback, because that went against what I researched and what I believed. And at that point, I realized two major things. One, you're truly happy when you have people you love, people you care for beside you, interacting with you. And second, that our elderly people in Singapore are not experiencing the same happiness. So what can we do about it? There's so much effort being put on the economic front of helping the elderly, and this comes in the form of bonus schemes and governmental support and facilities. But is that really what they need? When we take care of the elderly in the form of the economic front, we are becoming blind to their emotional needs, what truly affects them on the inside as a person. But there's so much more that we as youth can do about this situation, and yet we don't. And why is that? What exactly is this gap that exists between us and the elderly? We see the elderly around us every day. It's common to see them, even in train stations or most public places. Yet we turn a blind eye to their needs and challenges. And believe me, it's not because we want the elderly to not live a good life or enjoy the rest of their life. It's simply because we're indifferent. We're indifferent to their needs. And that is something that needs to be changed in order to bridge this gap. So how can we as youth bridge this gap? Now, I'm not going to be asking you to do much. It's actually really simple. And as they say, it's the simple things in life that count. So let's just take some time off from our social media or anything that restricts us from helping the elderly, anything that restricts us from going out and approaching the elderly. Let's just take some time to talk to an elderly person, to interact with them. And this doesn't necessarily mean to interact with a new elderly person or someone who you've never met. It can just be your grandparents. Just hear their stories and maybe even share your own experiences. It's not much when you think about it, but it's every small step counts. And trust me, I know from experience, it makes the day of an elderly person just that much better when you interact and talk with them. And there's a saying on the St. Joseph's Home's wall, and it goes, "An old person is full of priceless gifts." And as we interact with the elderly, the wisdom we gain is unparalleled. It's something that we can gain from no one else. And Abraham Lincoln once said, "You cannot escape the responsibility of tomorrow by, simply evading it today." And we as youth of today need to reconsider our role in an aging society. There needs to be a greater interaction between the elderly and us. And this is a call to adapt our personal and social lives to be one that is inclusive to all. It's a life worth spreading and a life of happiness. And we as youth can play a role in that. So let's not just become better students. Let's become better people. In every conceivable manner, the elderly are links to our past and the bridge to our future. It is our moral obligation to take care of the elderly. So we do have a role to play. So let's start today. Thank you.